Hello students, in the last class we have already seen the basic principles of nature cure according to Indian philosophy. Now this class we are going to study the six guiding principles of natural medicine according to Western philosophy. As you know that every medical fraternity is based on certain principles, and these principles are the guiding factors which are very crucial for the belief system in the belief in the system we follow. So these principles can lead us to greater understanding of the true nature and the whole nature of the concept which lay the foundation of our system. So in nature cure perspective, every practitioner must be guided by these six principles which we are going to learn today. Now you can look at this slides. There are six guiding principles in nature cure: do no harm, the healing power of nature, identify and treat the cause, the physician as teacher, treat the whole person, and prevention. Now six fundamental basic principles are: the first one is trusting in the body's inherent wisdom to heal itself, and the second point is to identify and treat the cause of the disease, not simply treating the symptoms of the disease. You have to find out the underlying cause of the disease. And the third principle is that first do no harm. This principle is proposed by the father of medicine, Hippocrates, and in this we mainly stress on the least invasive and least toxic therapies and use the most natural therapies so that the patient, we don't give any harm to the patient. Now the fourth principle is doctor as a teacher. That is, it's emphasized the role of a doctor as teacher. Educate the patient in the steps to achieving and maintaining health. Now the fifth one is treat the whole person. You know that the modern medicine is usually split the body into different specialities or different parts and then treat. But here we view the body as an integrated whole in its physical, spiritual dimensions. Now the last point is prevention. We focus on the overall health, wellness, and the disease prevention. These are the fundamental six basic principles in natural medicine. Now we are going to learn one by one in detail. I have already put the Latin phrases which are very common. These six principles are explained in the Latin term. The first one, that is the healing power of nature, is expressed as vis medicatrix naturae in Latin. And the second point, treat the whole person, is expressed in Latin as tole totum. And the treat the cause, the third principle, is expressed in Latin as tole causum. And the fourth one, first do no harm, is represented as primum non nocere. And the fifth one, doctor as teacher, is represented in Latin as docere. And the last one, disease prevention, is preventer. Now we are going to see each point one by one. Vis medicatrix naturae. With all the available means, body can protect and heal in itself if we give an opportunity for the body to heal. So this point, or this philosophy, believes in the self-supporting, self-governing, self-ruling, self-protecting, and self-purificatory and self-regenerative abilities of the body. Now we all know that, for example, we will take how the bone fractures heal. Whenever there is a fracture in the bone, you know, as for example, when we have a fracture in the clavicular bone, doctors, what they usually do is they just support your hand with the help of a sling and just leave it as it is. The bone heals by itself. By first it forms a hematoma around the fractured joints of the bone, and then there is increased vascularity to the area, then there is cellular proliferation, and then the callus is formed. Consolidation happens with the help of osteoblasts and osteoclasts, and then remodeling happens. All these happens by itself without the support of the external help. So the bone heals by itself. The best example is the clavicular fracture, where after a few months when you take the x-ray, you can see that the bone is healed. So this is one of the best example of vis medicatrix naturae. And let us come to the second point, which is known as tole totum, which means treat the person as a whole. Treating the whole person is known as a holistic approach to the treatment. Part cannot exist independently of the whole, and the parts of the whole are in intimate connection. And this concept emphasizes the need for treating the whole person and not the disease. But doctors of present era are trained to treat the body as compartments without looking into the psychological and socioeconomic risk factors which are related to the disease. The disease can be closely related to the mental status of the patient. So we have to talk to the patient, listen to them, and know the psychological factors and all the other factors which are contributing to the disease. Usually, the focus is on the biological risk factors and not on the psychological factors. In cardiovascular diseases, depression and anxiety has an adverse impact on the outcome and prognosis of the disease. So holism and reductionism, whenever you're talking about holism, we must also talk about reductionism. Holism explains that parts of a whole are in intimate interconnection in such a way that they cannot exist independently of the whole, the functions of which cannot be understood without the reference to the whole. Here we consider the body as a whole, not part by part, because part cannot exist independently. Whatever the part does is in connection with the whole. Whereas reductionism is the opposite of holism. In reductionism, we break down the part or reduce the part into small complex biological parts or traceable units, so it can be explained and understood easily. Example, specialization in modern medicine. You know that respiratory system is consisting of the upper respiratory tract, the nose, throat, and then the lower respiratory tract. But there is specialization in two different specializations are there for this. ENT is different and pulmonologist is different. So when you have a problem with the respiratory tract, they consider and see the disease as independent entities. They see only the ear and the nose and the throat region, and they do not consider the other part of the system, part of the body. Holistic approach. Holistic methods addresses more complex questions such as how do a person's sleeping habits, diet habits, living conditions, comorbidities, and stress collectively contribute to his or her disease or his present status. Reductionism neglects the complex interplay between the systems of the body, whereas nature cure treat the person and not the disease. Reductionism pervades the medical science and affects the way we diagnose and treat diseases. The disease becomes the central focus and not the person affected by it. Though reductionism has been responsible for tremendous success in modern medicine, there are limits to reductionism. Integrated approach to the treatment. As naturopathic physicians, we are taught to treat the whole person, including his body, mind, and spirit. Now, we have the responsibility and a unique opportunity to pave the way for a meaningful integration of body and soul while treating the patients. No other medical fraternity other than Nature Cure can claim the effect on physical, mental, and spiritual entities of the person. In yoga, you must have already studied the five sheets of existence of human body. And in yoga treats all the sheets irrespective of the disease. Whatever be the disease, it has interventions at each level of the human existence. Let us go to the third point. It is called tole causam, treat the cause. The third principle of natural medicine is treating the cause, root cause of the disease, finding the root cause and treating it. In contrast to modern medicine, where the cause of disease is attributed to pathological agents like bacteria and viruses, naturopathic medicine attributes the cause to the accumulation of the morbid matter. The accumulation of waste makes the person susceptible to bacteria and viruses. So according to Nature Cure, violation is the main root cause of the disease. Whereas in today's medical profession, we treat only symptoms. Nature Cure says there is only one cause and one cure. The one cause is the toxemia and one cure is removing the toxemia. The true healing happens only when you treat the root cause of the disease. And the fourth point is the primum non nocere, and which says that you first do no harm, which is not at all possible now, because every medicine today is a double-edged sword, and every cure has a potential harm, and we call this as adverse drug reactions or side effects. And when you search in the internet, you will get many number of diseases which starts with drug induced so and so. So next, fifth point is doctor as teacher. It is also called as a docere. And this doctor, the term doctor originates from the Latin word docere, meaning to teach. But physicians today has almost forgotten this role. The ancient rishis have rightly said that pragya pradhama roga karanam, which means the atrocity of intelligence is the cause of disease. Then in yoga and in the philosophy of nature cure, we think that the root cause of the disease is at the intellectual level. So it's very important to teach the patient, educate the patient about the causes of the disease and the need for correction and modification in the lifestyles and the way he thinks and perceives life and everything else in life. So health awareness programs are important, and doctor's role as a teacher is very, very important in preventing diseases. The sixth point is prevention. And prevention is better than cure. That is an age-old slogan which everybody knows. I need not explain much about prevention. But naturopathy acts as a preventive medicine. Preventive maintenance of the body is done through nature cure. That is why in nature cure, people come every year to renew and rejuvenate as a preventive maintenance of their health. Now, let us conclude the session. Once again, I'll remind you the six basic principles. That is healing power of nature, identifying the cause, first do no harm, doctor's role as a teacher, treat the whole person and prevent the disease. Before concluding, I want to put these principles in the present context of declining moral and ethical values in the clinical practice. People feel that comforting, caring and consoling has become the most uncommon thing in all systems of medical profession today. Nobility of the profession has gradually disappeared during the last three decades. Now, until three decades ago, a doctor enjoyed the status of Vaidyo Narayano Harihi, which means doctor is compared to a god. But today, the commercialization in the various systems of medicine and unethical approach changed the status. To bring back the status of the doctors, one must follow these six basic philosophical guidelines which were practiced in the ancient time. Now, let me conclude the session with the words of the Hippocrates. I caught his words: cure rarely, comfort mostly, and console always. Sometimes comforting and consoling a person is more important than giving a cure. Hope these principles will guide you in your clinical practice in future. Thank you for listening.